Ara, d'aquí un moment, començarà a fer un soroll a l'aioli, que aquí en diem trincar, que és aquest soroll que sentiu. Si se sent aquest soroll, és que anem bé. És que l'aioli i l'emulsió ens va perfecte. Jo crec que ens en sortirem, eh? Jo crec que anirà bé. Veieu aquest soroll? Aquest soroll és que anem perfecte. Jo crec que quasi bé el tindrem. Ja el tindrem a punt. Ja el tindrem a punt. I ara, per saber si està ben espès, hi ha una manera, que és girant-te'l. Aquí tenim una bona emulsió, ja ho veieu. Tirem una emulsió perfecta. I molt bona.
We saw Nando make one of the most delicious, most impressive kinds of emulsions, aioli. Aioli is like a garlic mayonnaise. It's very simple ingredients. It's garlic, salt, and olive oil. And what he does is he mixes the salt in with the garlic and he crushes the garlic. The salt pulls the water out of the garlic, and then the water from the garlic acts as the surfactant to stabilize the drops of the olive oil in the water. And you saw Nando slowly mix them together. He crushed the garlic, he pulled the water out, and he slowly mixed the olive oil in, slowly emulsified it. And ultimately, he made a solid emulsion. The only way the emulsion can be solid is if he emulsifies sufficient olive oil that you get these highly compressed drops. So they become elastic, they become solid. And if you watch Nando make it, sometimes what he'll do is he'll say the emulsion is about to break just as he's finishing it. And then he takes a few drops of water and adds it to the emulsion. The reason for that is that you're so close to phase inversion. You have so much olive oil and so little water that it can easily phase invert. And instead of having drops of oil in the water, you have a huge number of drops of oil in a relatively small amount of water, and you can end up with drops of water in oil. Then you have a very small amount of water as drops in oil, but you don't have an emulsion and you don't have a solid. Now, a simpler way of making an aioli is to add a surfactant. Garlic is not the best surfactant. That's why it's very difficult to make a true aioli. To make it much more easily, what Nando did was he added a really wonderful surfactant. So he took an egg yolk, he mixed it with the garlic and the water, and that then could much more easily emulsify all of the olive oil. Without the egg yolk, it's called aioli, and that's the most simplest form of an emulsion. It's also, to me, one of the most impressive forms of an emulsion because it's so little, so few ingredients, and yet you get the solid garlic-like mayonnaise. Eventually, however, emulsions will fail. So let's understand a little bit about what it means to have an emulsion fail. In order for an emulsion to fail, you have to lose the drops of one fluid in the second. So you have to lose the drops of the oil in the water. And there are several ways that this can happen. The first thing that will happen is the fact that the oil and the water have a different density. Typically, the oil is lighter than the water. Eventually, the oil drops will come to the surface. This will particularly be the case if the volume fraction is relatively low. And there are several ways that this can occur. The most obvious way is through coalescence. Two drops come close to one another and they join together and form a larger drop. Always, for the failure of an emulsion, you have to lose the drops, and so the drops have to become larger. It's the small drops that give the emulsion its particular character. But there is another more pervasive way that emulsions can fail and that drops can grow, and that is called Oswald ripening. And that is absolutely pervasive. It's almost impossible to completely eliminate Oswald ripening. Fortunately, it's a relatively slow process, so it's not so important oftentimes unless you store an emulsion for a very long time. And Oswald ripening is the transfer of fluid from one drop to another drop. And remember, drops are at a higher internal pressure than the outside. And the pressure inside, the Laplace pressure, increases as the drops get smaller. So there's a driving force, an increased pressure, to drive the fluid from the small drops into the large drops.